Hello guys, this video is about to set up Calendarly API. I think everyone knows about Calendarly and this is appointment scheduling software. So with this no-code tool, you can set up your Calendarly API and get the events and also invitees of a particular event. So let's start. So we'll log in to nocodeapi.com. Go to the marketplace, view marketplace. Find out the Calendarly application. Over here, activate this application and create. So you have to authenticate with your Calendarly account. So it will redirect back to your Calendarly page, login page. I was already authenticated, so it automatically logged in. And after that, it will come back to the Node API application page with this model and just give a name, whatever name you want to give this API. So my Calendarly API and create the button. So your Calendarly API is ready within 60 seconds. And you can use these endpoints to list of your events, list of event invitees. We have currently two endpoints. Just copy this endpoint and open into the browser and hit the enter. So you will get all the collection of your events that you have. So, and you can also parse some query parameters, status is active and canceled. You can also test this API inbuilt feature. If you click on this try it button, click on this, try it. You can pass the status is like active, is optional, but you can pass it if you want to pass. And you can pass the page, like which page and how much object you want in per page, like I want only two, and execute it. So you will result only two collection in your body. And this is your requested URL, and you can also copy this URL and then go to the browser and hit the enter this URL and you will get your two collection. And you can also next paginate pass page 2 and page 3, and you can also get the list of a particular event invitees. So you have to use this endpoint slash invitees, and if you enter, so you need UUID of event because it's a required parameter. So you can find the UID in this object. This is your UID of an event. Copy this UID and pass as a query parameter. So you will get the invitee of a particular that event. If you pass another one, just copy this, pass it, you will get another one. So this is super easy if you want to use this API into your project, into your automation. So you can make it your Calendarly API without any backend, without any server setup. There's a lot of benefit. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.